As discoveries go, this one seemed anticlimactic.
You got all sizes of them here, too.
5 years ago, Jeff Adams came to this spot near the town of John Day and found some crayfish as easily as he trapped more today.
There were hundreds and hundreds of crayfish at one of the sites that we looked at. Just the sheer numbers seemed very odd and out of place.
Other scientists checked his samples and realized these crayfish belong a couple thousand miles away.
Certainly it was a shock to see it up here. It's a well-known species to cause a lot of ecological damage in the upper Midwest, and it's never been found west of the Rockies, west of the Continental Divide. And that's a big concern when you see something hop a Continental Divide and invade a new region.
From Jeff's first spotting in 2005, rusty crayfish have sprinted downstream. They have now colonized 30 miles of the John Day River.
Right now, just kicking through the substrate with the back of my heels, and then the current of water will kind of dislodge the crayfish right into my net.
Professor Julian Olden of the University of Washington has been studying invasive species in the John Day River for several years.
They're pretty thick through here, so it's like a couple kicks. It's pretty much a crayfish under every rock. That's the reality of it.
It's a great catch, there's at least a dozen there.
This species are native to the upper Ohio River drainage in the Midwestern US, but now have been introduced to about 18 states and two Canadian provinces, ranging from Ontario and Quebec all the way down to Tennessee.
Oregon's native signal crayfish can appear either bright red or drab green.
The signal crayfish has beautiful brown olive color, has some nice white spots right on its claw. It's quite beautiful, nice and smooth crayfish.
Rusty crayfish may be green too, but they carry a trademark rust spot on their side. When aquatic invasives move around the country, there's a standard list of usual suspects. Anglers and their boats often give them unintentional rides, but not this time.
Here in the West, there seems to be kind of a unique pathway that hasn't really obtained that much attention. We see a quite different story here. Crayfish are used in the classroom. You know, they're using the classroom for a reason. I think they illustrate biological life quite well.
Well, we have the rusty crayfish in the tank right here.
I think they're pretty cool.
Yeah.
Crayfish are sturdy. They can survive a lot of handling. That makes them good for fourth and fifth graders who are learning about biology, ecosystems, and life cycles.
You can talk about it, you can look at a movie, but it's not the same as actually picking it up and learning how to hold the crayfish and what are the structures and how really unique are they.
Right here, this is where the egg would be if this was a female, but it's a male.
Don't be scared.
The rusty crayfish is one of several crayfish that are shipped around the country to roughly probably 25% of elementary classrooms throughout the United States. And usually they're shipped between a dozen to two dozen in each classroom.
The problem comes when the school year ends. What should they do with their living specimens?
Often it's done very innocently. Most people feel that the best thing to do is to return plants and animals to nature where they came from.
This is Dixon Creek. This is the main creek in Corvallis. And it's also a creek where at least flows through the backyards of four different elementary schools.
Dixon Creek now has invasive crayfish. Dr. Sam Chan of Oregon State says the schools that back up to the creek are very likely the source. Every time a red swamp crayfish from Louisiana or a rusty crayfish from the upper Midwest comes head to head with Oregon's native signal crayfish, the signal loses. At Franklin School in Corvallis, Jennifer England has been teaching with live animals for 15 years.
Skim and see if you can find something about how to care for them.
It was only 3 years ago she learned that supply companies were shipping her an invasive species.
He's mad at you, Conan.
Fortunately, she had never dumped live animals in streams.
They would use their back tail and they would flap it back and forth.
Experts at Oregon State suggested this could make a good lesson for her kids.
It blossomed, it grew immensely and became quite a good project.
It will eat the fish eggs that are in the rivers, and they will also kick the native crayfish out of their habitats.
They'll go in there and they'll just take over their homes, and then they'll normally destroy them, and then they can't find any place to go, and so the natives will die off. And
their students are learning about invasive species while learning about science.
After caring for their crayfish for months, the children often aren't wild about killing them. But they're learning that may be the only responsible option.
I don't think he likes it. You should put him back in the water so he can exhale.
Sometimes we just wait until they just die of old age.
We actually put them in a bag and put them in the freezer. And so that was a very painless way for them to go. We didn't have to put them out into the ecosystem that we have over here.
Wildlife officials say it's against state and federal law to ship these crayfish into Oregon or Washington. Oregon wildlife officials sent warning letters a couple of years ago to the major supply companies. The shipments have continued, but officials have not chosen to aggressively enforce the law. A couple of years ago, even Professor Olden discovered how easy it was to obtain an illegal shipment of invasive crayfish.
And that was probably the most shocking moment, a box full of non-native crayfish that we just got, you know, delivered right to our door.
He traced crayfish shipments to schools near the John Day River, too. Now this river has at least 30 miles of invasive crayfish. Only distance and time stand between here and the Columbia River.
You can contain fish by using electrical barriers, like they do in some systems in the Midwest, but there's no way of containing crayfish in large river systems like this.
5 years ago, on this stretch of river, Jeff Adams found only one rusty crayfish.
Yesterday, when I got back here for the first time in 5 years, the second my foot hit the water, I probably saw 30 or 40 scatter away. So it's a pretty dramatic difference.
Since crayfish shipments continue to classrooms, Northwest scientists will focus their efforts on teaching the teachers and their children.
Yeah, these have little hairs on their feet to feel it.
Just can't release animals that are in your care into the surrounding waters, because once they're there, particularly in water, you just can't get rid of them.
Great people just doing their thing in their own Northwesty way. We love bringing you stories like this. Support what you love. OPB.org/video.